Nanotechnology is nothing new, but just people trying to study the property of material that is really, really small, at least 1,000th of times smaller than the red blood cell. Everybody knows gold. Gold is good, right? We know that gold is metal, right? So if we really chop gold into a very, very tiny, small size, actually their properties start to change. Then their property become from a metal to a semiconductor. That can be used in different kind of applications. So if you actually attach antibodies to those gold particles and use that antibody to target certain specific cancer cells or bacteria, so they actually will attach to those cancer cells or bacteria and locally. Then you can shine an infrared light and then locally heat up those gold particles. So when the temperature rises, then the cell will be killed. So that is another way to use those nanoparticles to do some targeted disease treatment. I always have a dream when I started working on this nanomotor. So whether we can actually making a micro-sized robot that consists of nano-sized parts. And then those machinery actually can function like a very smart robot that can identify, here is a bad cells. And then I can capture it, then I can destroy it. So I'm thinking that, can we use those nanomotor to do stroke treatment? How about if we can making those nanomotor okay, close to the blood clot and then make them move, and can that enhance the stroke treatment? Recently, we start to also loading the drugs onto those nanomotor. If there's a drug presented in the blood vessel, they can actually accelerate the blood clot dissolving. So right now we just demonstrate in principle it can be done. If we can really apply that to a real patient treatment and to help like my mom and my dad, right? And to get rid of the stroke, that will be wonderful.